There's nothing quite like the holiday season. It's the best time of the year, but also far and away one of the most hectic. Simplify what you eat with Factor, America's number one ready-to-eat meal delivery service. My wife's a teacher, and Factor's had her covered for lunches at school. The jalapeno cheddar chicken is her favorite meal so far, while I've quickly taken to the creamy Parmesan chicken and green pepper and beef casserole as Ole Miss football rings in the postseason and its prime recruiting season. We haven't skipped a beat at our house because we can rely on Factor. Factor's fresh, never frozen meals are ready in just 2 minutes. All you have to do is heat and enjoy. What are you waiting for? Head on over to factormeals.com/TOC50 and use our special Talk of Champions promo code TOC50 to get 50% off. That's right, factormeals.com/TOC50 and promo code TOC50 to get 50% off. Continue to support your wellness goals while feeling your best this holiday season. Try Factor today, a proud sponsor of the Talk of Champions podcast network.
Rebel Nation, are you ready? It's time for the Cannon Motors of Mississippi Rebel Yell Hotline.
He gets the blocks he needs. He's in the end zone. Touchdown, Ole Miss. Straight in the middle, it's a first down and more. See you later. It's going to be a touchdown for Judkins.
Right up the middle, David. Big gaping hole opened up, and Judkins just burst through there.
Gary Darby, Chuck Roundsville, Yancey Porter, and Gordon Ford bring you the latest on everything going on with Ole Miss Athletics.
Gets control in the dock. Oh, my.
Don't sit on the sidelines. Be part of the show. Text in your questions or comments at 662-426-1093. That's 662-426-1093.
I guess you don't have to, but you need to.
He hits one high and deep left field. Kane shading the eyes at the track, and it is gone.
Let's get to it. Here's your host, Gary Darby.
Welcome to the Rebel Yell Hotline here with Cannon Motors. We have our host out today, Chucky, with Gary. Good luck to him. He has some wisdom teeth taken out. We're excited for this Egg Bowl. Two technology challenge people here are going to try to figure this out. Chucky, what did you think about the start of the game?
The start? Why didn't they just stay in bed? Just play the second half? Kind of rocky there. I don't know. A little sleepwalking going on. But, you know, everything's well that ends well. And they pulled it together at halftime, woke up from their nap, and 28-0 in the second half. So that's okay. That's acceptable. And, you know, sandwiched in between Georgia and their rival, Egg Bowl coming up Thursday, quick turnaround. I get it. You know, I get it. I'm not going to be too harsh on them. But the first half wasn't very pretty.
No, it wasn't. By the way, this is brought to you by South Farm Credit. With over 100 years of experience supporting rural communities and agriculture, we will help guide you through financial journey at South Farm Credit. Chuck, I thought the big thing there to me was in the second half, Jackson Dart kind of getting in a rhythm again. You didn't want him going into that state game not in a rhythm after the Georgia game. You know, he got stung there with his shoulder there in the third quarter, and just him getting in the rhythm again, I thought that was very important moving forward.
Yeah, and you could tell the first half he was really frustrated just by the whole thing. And even after the post-game interview, he's expressed a lot of frustration, said he was glad that things turned around in the second half, and so was a relieved crowd that ULM was – no longer a threat.
Yeah, and offensive line got off to a rough start, gave up three sacks, I believe two there in the first half. Lane mentioned in today's press conference that wasn't all the offensive line's fault. There was some running back issues there. You know, tight end and receivers, everybody kind of was a part of not playing its best blocking.
Contributed. Well, here's the thing people don't understand. Sometimes it takes a long time to make an offensive line cohesive, and where they're working is one person. And when you take out Micah Pettis, gone for the year, you're shifting Jeremy James out to right tackle. You're bringing up Reese McIntyre to play center. You're moving Caleb Warren over to right guard. Jaden Williams gets hurt the first series against Georgia. So, you know, Victor Kern and Quincy McGee were the only stable parts of the whole thing, whole offensive line Saturday. There just wasn't any cohesiveness early on, but they worked it out a little better in the second half. So hopefully by Thursday they can get things fixed, because Micah Pettis isn't coming back. Lane hinted that Jaden Williams might or should be able to play Thursday, but we'll see on that too.
Yeah, that's going to be a big factor to me going forward in this Egg Bowl, is will Jaden Williams return? If he does return, how healthy is he going to be? These are five thoughts from myself, brought to you by Outback Steakhouse and our friend Steve Grantham, who currently operates 9 Outback Steakhouses locations in Mississippi and Tennessee. My first thought, Ole Miss has to get its offensive line issues somehow resolved by Thursday. Losing 2 of their 3 top offensive tackles has sent them into disarray. Things got a little better in the second half, but was that due to ULM's depth issues or them actually gelling? Let's hope for the latter. Thought number 2, I thought Jackson Dart started knocking the rust off in the third quarter, and that will be critical for the Egg Bowl. You don't want your star quarterback coming in not sharp for rivalry week. Thought number 3, the Rebels were obviously sleepwalking in the first half, but they didn't let the Georgia hangover carry into the second half. The offense, defense, and special teams all started playing much better. Like Dart, it's important for the team to get back to somewhat in the rhythm before the Egg Bowl. Thought number 4, has anyone else noticed the development of freshman transfer defensive back Chris Graves? I have, and it couldn't have come at a better time. Chris has the ability to play in space, and that has been a problem for some of the Ole Miss defensive backs this season. And the last thought of the day, this is a chance for Ole Miss to get to 10-2 while playing Bama and Georgia on the road. There was no room for error. You win the next 2, and it would mark the most wins by Ole Miss in school history. Does anything else need to be said?
Good stuff. Are you going to sign us out, or are you just going to be a lousy host?
Next up, we'll have Romaro Miller coming up after the break.
When you think car, we want you to think Cannon. Whether you're in the market for gas, hybrid, or electric vehicles, our team has got you covered. We're invested in your future and in seeing that you have the experience you deserve, even after you get your car. Pre-order or bring home a new Chevrolet Silverado or a Chevrolet pre-owned vehicle from Cannon Chevrolet of Oxford today. And remember, when the smoke clears, nobody beats a Cannon deal. Nobody. Chevrolet, find your road.
What does the farm mean to you? Maybe it's a piece of land for production, crops, or cattle. Or maybe the farm is just a place you can go to relax or enjoy the outdoors. Whatever the farm means to you, First South Farm Credit can help you finance or refinance that perfect piece of land. We've been financing farms and land since 1916 with competitive rates and flexible terms. For more information, go to firstsouthland.com. Equal housing lender.
Cannon Cleary McGraw is ranked Oxford's number one real estate firm because of fans like you. The agents of Cannon Cleary McGraw are true experts in their field, and it shows with hundreds of five-star reviews and unwavering commitment to their clients. Cannon Cleary McGraw experts specialize in game day condos, seasonal townhomes, and high-end single-family homes. If you are on the sidelines and ready to get in the game, give a Cannon Cleary McGraw agent a call today at 662-371-1000. Tilt the odds in your favor of getting what you want with the best service in Oxford at Cannon Cleary McGraw Real Estate. If you're in the market for a fine piece of jewelry, there's only one name to know, Van Atkins. Serving its customers since 1939, Van Atkins has been voted the best estate jeweler in Mississippi multiple times. With great locations to serve you in historic downtown New Albany and on the square in Oxford, Van Atkins is the place to go. Whether it's a piece for yourself or for that special someone, Van Atkins is the easy decision. And like Chuck always says,
you know she's worth it.
Oxford Orthopedic and Sports Medicine board-certified surgeons are specially trained for you and your family, from dad's knee replacement to your son's football injury. Leaders in orthopedic care, Oxford Orthopedic can treat any of your orthopedic needs close to home. Locations in Oxford, Batesville, Grenada, Hernando, Cleveland, Calhoun City, and Pontotoc. Official orthopedic team physicians for Ole Miss Athletics. To make an appointment, call 662-513-2000. Or visit oxfordortho.org.
Gamble Clinic Orthopedics, a national and international leader in musculoskeletal care, are the ones to trust when it comes to orthopedic needs, such as sports medicine, pediatrics, hip and knee, spine, shoulder and elbow, foot and ankle, hand and wrist, as well as cast and x-ray services, along with a physical therapy department. To make an appointment, call 901-759-3111 or schedule online now at www.campbellclinicoxford.com. They also offer a convenient weekly walk-in clinic Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. until 4 p.m. Gamble Clinic Oxford, located at 2608 South Lamar Boulevard.
You're listening to the Rebel Yell Hotline, presented by Cannon Motors.
Welcome back here to the Cannon Motors Rebel Yell Hotline. Chucky and I are going to get all the technology here together. We have a special host, special guest, here, Romaro Miller, who I still say threw the prettiest ball I've ever seen at Ole Miss. Romaro, how are you, big guy?
I'm doing pretty good. How about you guys?
We're doing great.
Romaro, one of my favorite memories of Egg Bowl, and I don't know if it's yours or not, but when Deuce threw a pass to you. And you scored on your senior year to kind of ice that game. Talk about being a receiver for once.
Man, Chuck, I tell people all the time, quarterback has some of the best hands on the team. Because all we do is throw and catch and practice all this. All we do is throw and catch, warming up and stuff like that, you know. So I knew that if he got it to me, I was going to catch it. I just didn't have faith that he was going to get it to me. But he did, so it was definitely a good thing.
Talk about your experiences in the Egg Bowl, Romaro. I know one year, the year that Tuberville left, you were injured and couldn't play in it. Mississippi State won in Oxford when our friend David Morris was quarterbacking. But just give us some of your memories of the Egg Bowl.
Well, you know, my first year was the year we went down to Starkville, and we beat them on a two-point conversion late in the game when Stewart hit Corey Peterson for the touchdown.
Yeah.
And that kind of got me into the rival at a young age because, you know, that was the game also that we got into the fight pregame. So if you didn't know about the rivalry beforehand, you knew about it leaving Starkville that night. And, you know, just to accommodate my senior year to catch a pass and a lasting memory, not only for myself, but anytime I go back to games now, people always say, hey, I remember when Deuce threw you that pass. So it kind of makes me feel good.
Talk about the intensity of that game. I mean, there's just a little bit extra for Mississippi kids, isn't it?
Oh, no doubt. You know, being from Shannon, I grew up 55 minutes from Starkville, pretty much in 55 minutes an hour of Oxford. Half of my family, they Bulldogs. They converted over to Ole Miss when I was playing, but they went back over to Bulldogs once it was over. And even now, we'll get together on Thanksgiving and we'll talk crap about it beforehand and watch the game together. And just hopefully this year we come out on top so we can talk a little bit more crap than those guys.
Well, you know, I know that you do a lot of traveling to follow the Rebels. You're one of the former players that's about as loyal as any that I've ever seen. Do you go to Starkville or not?
No, Chuck, I haven't been down there. We were down there my junior year, and it was a bad night for me to end it. And I told myself, I said, man, I'll never go back to an Egg Bowl down there again. And as of to this day, I haven't been back down there yet. Feel good about this year's team. If there was a year I was going to go down, I think I would go this year just because of how I feel. But I can do it out here in those cowbells.
Yeah, I know. Hey, talk about this team a little bit and Lane Kiffin, the program he's building here, the NIL, the whole works. You being a former player, I know it's going in the right direction, and you got to be happy.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. When Lane came in, we thought we got the right guy, but we just didn't know. And just to see what he's doing and what he's been able to do and hopefully continue to do past this season right here. You know, right now we got a chance to finish this sucker off at 2, get us in a quality bowl game. I needed me another vacation, so I'm praying. I got a couple favorites I want to go to because, like I said, I need me a vacation. But whatever they do, we're gonna be there. We're going to support them.
I know you will, and the last thing you need is another vacation because I follow you on X, and I know how you and the bride travel. I know you have a lot of fun. But playing in this offense, if you were Jackson Dart, is this a quarterback's dream offense, or how would you like to play in this offense?
Man, I tell you, it's a quarterback dream because, you know, you think about everybody used to think about Lane's a passing guy, but – I mean, man, they run the ball. They run the ball up there with any team in the SEC. If you look at it consistently, his offense, he always going to have a running back to put up some major yards. And you know, just that takes so much pressure off you, and it opens up the passing game for you. And Jackson just continually show his knowledge of the offense and growing, especially the leap that he made from last year to this year, and hopefully just continue.
Talk about that leap a little bit. You know a lot more football than I do. What have you seen out of Jackson as far as his growth from year to year?
Just his knowledge of the offense. He knows exactly where everybody's going to be. And you can't put a price on that. You know, can't put any type of thing on that. I'm quite sure if Lane let him call plays, I'm quite sure he can – go out there and call a couple plays and get us on down the field a little bit, you know. But, no, just his knowledge, just being there, being in the system, nothing has changed for him. Your knowledge, you're always going to take your game to the next level. And hopefully he come back next year. And if he come back next year, I can just imagine how good he's going to be in the system.
Romero, speaking of this game coming up Thursday, what is the biggest important factor to you for Ole Miss to win this game? I know a lot of Ole Miss fans are worried about the offensive line right now, including me. What does Ole Miss have to do to win Thursday?
I just think we just got to go down and just play our game. Don't turn the ball over. I think clearly we're a better team than them this year. We just can't go down there and shoot ourselves in the foot. I've been down there where some crazy stuff happened in Starkville. And hopefully we come out early, get up on them 7-0, and make them try to chase us from behind. And I feel like if we can do that, we'll be okay.
Crazy things happen down there. Correct me if I'm wrong. Would you throw the pass that the defensive back kicked with his foot up in the air to another defensive back?
Yeah, man. That was, like I said, that was the last time I went to Starkville to the Egg Bowl. And that's the reason why I don't go back.
That one play? Yeah. Yeah, that was a killer.
That one play. I just remember their crowd running across the field as we were leaving, and I said, "Man, never again!" And I'm not going back again.
Well, Romero, catch everybody up on what you're doing now with your career.
Oh man, Chuck, I'm on the other side, man. Now I'm an alum, man. I have a State Farm agency here in Olive Branch. We service the entire state of Mississippi, Tennessee, Alabama, Louisiana, and Arkansas. But we're here. We're here to service the people. So if anybody looking for an insurance, you'll give us a call. We're on the internet.
What is the phone number, Romero? How does everybody get in touch with you?
662-893-1212, or you can just Google Romero Miller Insurance, and it'll pop up on the internet.
Thank you, Ro. We really appreciate it. And hotty toddy.
Hey, buddy. Thank you.
All right, hotty toddy, man. Y'all have a good Thanksgiving.
You too. Take care, buddy.
Always been one of my favorites, Joe.
Oh, man. Listen, let me tell you something. Yancey, and I'm not knocking any kid that doesn't want to come back and support the team that played here. they have their lives. People have to live their own lives and make their own decisions. But I guarantee you, Romaro Miller's going to be there.
Yeah.
And he always has ever since he's graduated from Ole Miss. He's a proud Rebel. He's a supporting Rebel, both financially and with his presence. And just a fine young man. And I know his insurance agency in Olive Branch is doing well, and he deserves it.
Yeah, he certainly does. And you just remember that class. I think that was the class before you put out the infamous video there that, was sold under there on the Tuberville. But Deuce McAllister, Terrence Metcalf, all those guys, they stayed so connected with the program. And that's just, you don't see that much, not only at Ole Miss, but any program.
Yeah. I'll tell you a quick story about Romaro. When we were recruiting him, I was doing recruiting for the Atlantic Constitution Journal. And so I wouldn't call recruits and say I'm with the Ole Miss Spirit, because then they'd say what you wanted to hear about Ole Miss.
Oh, yeah.
And I called Romaro and I said, I'm with the Atlanta Constitution Journal. Where you think you're going to go to school? And he said, is this Chuck? I said, yeah. He said, you with the Ole Miss Spirit. You're not with the Atlanta Constitution. He caught me red-handed. We'll be right back with Cannon Motors Mississippi Rebel Yell Hotline after these important messages. Hang tight.
Can you imagine years of hard work and saving, and now you're worried about outliving your retirement savings? Paxton Farese and the Farese Group have over 20 years and a process working toward success, not stress, after retirement. To know how you can truly enjoy a level of comfort and security, talk to the Farese Group. Retirement should be stress-free, not stressful. The Farese Group, FariseGroup.com, offices in Oxford and Jackson. The Farese Group, your partner in retirement. Securities offered through LPL Financial, member FINRA and SIPC.
Big Delta Power Sports on Cracker Barrel Drive in Batesville celebrates 20 years in business this year. Check out the great selection now of major brands like Honda, Polaris, Can-Am, Yamaha, and Kawasaki, featuring the most fun off the road and on the road. Motorcycles, ATVs, and side-by-sides. Zero-turn mowers. Plus, you'll find generators by Honda and Polaris. And Big Delta is your steel power equipment dealer. Celebrating 20 years in business, whether it's work or play. Big Delta Power Sports in Batesville.
Outback Steakhouse knows steak. Even better, the grills are always hot and ready for your favorites. There's nothing better than pairing a bold steak with a bloomin' onion and one of our signature cocktails. Drop in for a great lunch or dinner anytime for awesome food and a bloomin' good time. Either way, Outback has your back. Visit their locations in Tupelo, Hattiesburg, Meridian, South Haven, D'Iberville, and Flowood, Mississippi. Also serving Jackson and Cordova, Tennessee. Outback Steakhouse. House cleaning is just one of those things you gotta do. But life is busy, and the great folks at Brittany's Cleaning Services understand that and are here to help. They provide professional cleaning services for residential, commercial, and rental properties. Reliable, honest, experienced cleaners with affordable pricing. Servicing Olive Branch, Tupelo, Water Valley, Bruce, Holly Springs, Pontotoc, Oxford, Taylor, New Albany, South Haven, Senatobia, and Batesville. Call for more information at 662-202-8868 and follow them on social media. That's Brittany's Cleaning Services, LLC. Hey, Rebel fans, want to be more involved with Ole Miss? Well, join the Grove Collective, the exclusive Ole Miss NIL program. With the new name, image, and likeness law, Rebel fans now have the opportunities to support and elevate Ole Miss student-athletes, and the Grove Collective has created a unified portal to amplify that support. As part of the Grove Collective, your support opens access to special events, fan experiences, merchandise, and marketing opportunities with student-athletes. To find out more and to become part of the Grove Collective NIL program, visit thegrovecollective.com. Hotty Toddy and go Rebs.
More of the Rebel Yell Hotline, presented by Cannon Motors, coming up next.
My friend. Welcome back here to the Cannon Motors Rebel Yell Hotline, and we're going to open up here with the weekly text messages that everybody wants to know about your Ole Miss Rebels. And the first one is here. And, Chucky, what do you think that they want to know? They want to know about the offensive linemen.
Offensive line.
Has Ole Miss got any offensive linemen on the deck for next year? Well, to answer your question, they have two right now that are committed, and both of them. The good news is, no, it's not many, but they were two very, very important guys that they had tagged from day one, Chuck. And that's what I always go off of, covering recruiting, I guess, what for 25 years, is really more about the guys that are big-time targets for your university and who the coaches really want. And John Wayne Oliver is the first one here that we're speaking about. He's out of Christ Presbyterian Academy in Nashville, Tennessee. He's 6'5", 280-pound. He'll probably play offensive guard. Some project him at center. I see him more as an offensive guard. Big-time player that Ole Miss was able to win over a lot of big-time schools to get that commitment there. As we know, they don't sign until December the 20th, which is 1 month away. And then the second one is Jude Foster at a Southern University Lab School in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Another interior offensive lineman, probably settled there at offensive guard. He's 6'4", 295. Again, Ole Miss was able to battle a bunch of big-time schools and come out with that commitment. So, Chucky, for that very first question there about future offensive linemen, as we see, the numbers aren't big, only two. We don't know how many that are going to leave the team. You know, most of these offensive linemen have a COVID year left, so we'll see about the attrition. But I know that you believe that Ole Miss is going to be very active in the portal to fill out another slot or two.
Well, yeah, but here's the first thing, though. I really believe that Caleb Warren is going to be back. I think Reese McIntyre will be back. Micah Pettis has no reason not to come back, particularly after he got injured. Jaden Williams has an opportunity to come back. Jeremy James, I think, will come back. So that's a lot of experience there. And then on top of that, you've got young guys like Preston Cushman, freshman Bryson Sanders, who I think has a really good future. Cam East, he's got to put on a few more pounds, but I think he's making good progress. Cedric Melton is a guy that has played some ball here but just hadn't broken through this year. So, I mean, don't act like the cupboard is bare, but at the same time, it does need reinforcements, and I think it's going to be critical to get a couple of guys like we got Victor Kern this past year that's been a very good player for us at left tackle. You know, so I think we need a couple of Victor Kerns for sure.
Yeah, and that's the thing about it, Chucky, is when you're only playing five, six offensive linemen a game, you mentioned four of those younger players, all redshirt freshmen, true freshmen there that Chuck mentioned there. It makes you feel uneasy because you haven't seen them play. You don't know what they could do. But that's where you got to trust the staff and the development of these players. But having said that, I still look for Ole Miss to get at least one or two out of that portal. The second question of the day, text message to us, is Suntarian Perkins hurt? It's kind of like the Chandon Ward years, isn't it? Like, where is Git?
Well, he's playing more than people think. I mean, they need to pay attention because he's in the rotation at defensive end for sure with Cedric Johnson and Ukwu and Perkins. They're all in the rotation, so I mean he's playing 35, 40 plays a game normally, and but he's just, I don't know, people just don't see number four out there for some reason.
Yeah, it's just like Channing Ward. And the text messages here are presented by Cannon, Cleary, and McGraw at ccmoxford.com. You can reach them also by dialing 662-371-1000. Ask for my boy Mark Cleary, and he will definitely get anything you need to do with the Oxford real estate. Chuck, on to the injury report here. You know, I know that Coach Lane said that there's a chance that Williams returns Thursday. Nobody's going to know that to the game time, but kind of fill us in with some of the injuries.
I don't think there's anything else to worry about except Michael Pettis is out, and that's a big out. You know, yeah. I mean, he's a quality right tackle that – we certainly miss. Jeremy James has slid out there doing his, you know, he's played right tackle before, but it's been a while, so he's probably having to knock the rust off. And plus, Pettis and James had just started playing so well together when Pettis got hurt. We still don't know what the mystery is with wide receivers Zachary Franklin. Apparently, he's just – it still hadn't come back from that knee injury fully 100% that had in August got repaired. It must have been a lot more extensive than they let on. But anyway, he's kind of missing in action, and they don't know what's going on right really with Zachary right now.
Do you think Zachary, I know maybe we don't need to speculate, but he's played his last days at Ole Miss?
I would think so.
Yeah.
I would think so. And I say played his last days. He hardly played.
Barely played.
You know.
But I think Lee's development there, and what a nifty run he made there, the freshman there on that 52-yard catch. He's really coming. He can.
He can burn now.
He really can. And the injury report here is always provided, as they have from day one here with Oxford Ortho and our boy Daniel Boyd. Dan is as good as anybody in town, as the Porter family can attest. So we got the next segment coming up here. We'll be with Harry Harrison, our game day outlook, and with the Ole Miss Football Radio, former All-American here, Rebel, and we look forward to his insight.
Grab a seat at a cocktail in the sports bar to watch the game on one of their many big screen TVs. Move on into the middle bar for some great live music Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night. Enjoy a breeze, a beer, and a ball game out on their patio as well. Stop in for happy hour from 3 to 7 during the weekdays. Have a big old time at the biggest bar in town. Meet you at the Brary, the Library Sports Bar on South 11th in Oxford.
Cannon Cleary McGraw is ranked Oxford's number one real estate firm because of fans like you. The agents of Cannon Cleary McGraw are true experts in their field, and it shows with hundreds of five-star reviews and unwavering commitment to their clients. Cannon Cleary McGraw experts specialize in game day condos, seasonal townhomes, and high-end single-family homes. If you are on the sidelines and ready to get in the game, give a Cannon Cleary McGraw agent a call today at 662-371-1000. Tilt the odds in your favor of getting what you want with the best service in Oxford at Cannon Cleary McGraw Real Estate.
Roof leaks can disturb your relaxing weekend or put your business operations and assets in jeopardy. Riverland Roofing is a licensed, insured, and certified roofing contractor that offers clients quality solutions that suit their budget. As a certified GAF master contractor, Riverland can offer warranties that can last a lifetime, servicing five states, including Mississippi and Tennessee. Owned and operated by Ole Miss alumni, Riverland Roofing covers what matters most, home or business. Find out more at riverlandllc.com or call 844-901-ROOF.
Make Lenora's in Oxford your go-to dinner play this season. Their daily ravioli is always amazing, and you cannot go wrong with the decadent crawfish mac and cheese. They have an excellent variety of seafood dishes, and their ribeyes and fillets are cooked to perfection every time. Have a taste of the weekend on Wine Wednesdays, too. Call for your reservation today at 662-236-1144. That's 236-1144. Located at 309 North Lamar, great food and great vibes. It's a winning combination. Hey, cheers, and see you at Lenora's.
When you think car, we want you to think Cannon. Whether you're in the market for gas, hybrid, or electric vehicles, our team has got you covered. We're invested in your future and in seeing that you have the experience you deserve, even after you get your car. Pre-order or bring home a new Chevrolet Silverado or a Chevrolet pre-owned vehicle from Cannon Chevrolet of Oxford today. And remember, when the smoke clears, nobody beats a Cannon deal. Nobody. Chevrolet, find your road.
Outback Steakhouse knows steak. Even better, the grills are always hot and ready for your favorites. There's nothing better than pairing a bold steak with a bloomin' onion and one of our signature cocktails. Drop in for a great lunch or dinner anytime for awesome food and a bloomin' good time. Either way, Outback has your back. Visit their locations in Tupelo, Hattiesburg, Meridian, South Haven, D'Iberville, and Flowood, Mississippi. Also serving Jackson and Cordova, Tennessee. Outback Steakhouse.
Are you looking for a quality used car at a price fit for your budget? No worries, Automotive Group has locations in Batesville, Olive Branch, South Haven, and Memphis. No credit check, no driver's license, no worries. Every vehicle comes with a 30-month, 30,000-mile service contract. Let our friendly and knowledgeable sales staff help you find the car you deserve. Remember, we have locations in Batesville, Olive Branch, South Haven, and Memphis. Find us anytime, anywhere at noworriescars.com.
Ole Miss football, basketball, baseball, and more are all right here on the Rebel Yell Hotline, presented by Cannon Motors.
Welcome back here to the Cannon Motors Rebel Yell Hotline. We're to the game day outlook. We're going to have Harry Harrison on very shortly here. But, Chuck, let's look at the game Thursday. We talked about the offensive line. That's, obviously the point number one, that things are going to have to come together a little bit better than we saw the last game and a half. What are some other matchups that are important for Ole Miss for you?
Well, we got to remember we're going to Starkville, and we're not very well liked over there, and the cowbells will be ringing. So noise is going to be an issue, I'm pretty sure, even though things are in disarray and chaos over there from firing their coach a couple of weeks ago. I can promise you that I know Greg Knox very well, and Greg's going to have them pumped up and ready to go. I don't know if you saw the little YouTube clip or Instagram clip.
Riding in on a four-wheeler.
That's not a team that's quit. No. They haven't quit. And they showed that by beating the socks off of Southern Mississippi. Of course, everybody's beating Southern Mississippi this year. But at the same time, the Bulldogs have some life in them, and we've got to be ready for that.
Yeah, welcome on to the show here. It's Harry Harrison, the former All-American safety for Ole Miss. And Harry, I was asking Chuck, obviously with the offensive line issues, that's what all Ole Miss fans are keying on. But what are a matchup or two you're really going to focus on?
Well, yeah, obviously starts in the trenches, Yancey, in the offensive line. That's why I was running a little late. I was at practice and had those darn cowbells playing. I forgot how disgusting they were, but they were blasting them out there. But it looked like we're going maybe with Caden Warren back at center and moving McIntosh to right guard, moving some pieces around. And I did see Jaden Williams. He was dressed out, still hobbling pretty good, but maybe by Thursday he'll be able to go a little bit. We hope so. But that's the key. I mean, it was a little bit in disarray on last Saturday in the first half, and it got better as a week went on. But what I really think is I really believe our defensive line can dominate in this football game. I don't think that Mississippi State's offensive line is as good as we've played in the last few weeks, excluding ULM, of course. But I just think that our defensive line can certainly have a good night there.
Yeah, and you returned Rodgers, who's not the most mobile guy, so that could work in Ole Miss's favor there. And let's not forget, Rodgers has been out for, about a month and a half before he returned this past Saturday against Southern Miss. So he's still got some rust to knock off as well. And, that's a very, very good point, Harry. I think State's offensive line has really struggled all season. Chuck, is there another position or two you're going to focus on?
No, but I don't want to underestimate Will Rodgers. He's got a guy that's got a lot of starts and a lot of experience under his belt. He gets rid of the ball really quickly. He doesn't have a strong arm, but he's got a real accurate arm. And I just don't think we can discount that experience. Do you, Harry?
No, I don't think so either, Chuck. But I just believe our defensive front's going to be able to put some pressure on him. And that's the key. Even when they're in the damn air raid, that we were able to get pressure on him, that was the key. Back when Sam Williams was getting all those sacks that year down there, we got pressure on him. That disrupted their passing attack, and that's what I'm hoping again. Of course, that all starts up front with not letting the run game get going. And somebody told me that Tula Griffin went out with an injury maybe third quarter the other day, never came back, and so did their running back, Woody Marks. So we'll have to see, see if those guys are ready to play. I'm sure if they're any way possible, they're going to play against the Rebels come Thursday.
Yeah, but I tell you, without them, those are two big losses if they don't play. They're almost as important as Will Rogers to their offense. So
yeah, no doubt.
I think Tulu's going to be fine. I think he's. I don't think he's very happy right now at Mississippi State. Now that could be some of the equation too. But with Woody, you know, he's been fighting various leg injuries all season. I believe he had a hamstring issue earlier this year. That's a good running back now. Woody
really
is. Very,
he really yeah. is. And they tried to lean on that run game more this year than they have in the past. Obviously, getting away from that air raid offense, and it just hadn't worked. You know, they've had some moments here and there in games, but it just by and large hadn't worked. And that's why Will Rogers has struggled. And you know, just changed an offense in his last year, and he struggled with that. It's not the air raid anymore. And so when you don't have that run game going, and you get one dimensional, then it's tough on a quarterback, and especially if you get pressure on him, and I think a lot of teams have. So that's the key. Can we man up on the outside, you know, bring some blitzes, put some pressure on him? I think that'll be the cat and mouse game that Pete Golden will have to dial up as the game wears on.
But, you know, let's talk a little bit about abandoning the air raid. I mean, they recruited for 3 or 4 years to the air raid, and this guy comes in, Arnett comes in, and decides to ditch what their personnel is fit for. It just, I don't know. No wonder he got fired. I mean, and bless his heart, I don't want anybody to lose their job. But, golly, to me, that was about as boneheaded as it gets. Why not recruit to whatever you want to run down the future, but use your personnel the way they were recruited to play?
Well, it makes total sense to me and you, Chuck, that that's the way it should have been. But, you know, he went out and hired an offensive coordinator and I guess allowed him to change the offense. And all it did was get him fired. Now, you know, it's one of those jobs that you can get fired, still make a lot of money going out. I don't know what else you can do to make more money than head coaches getting fired in the SEC. But I don't think his buyout was probably quite as hefty as Jimbo's. But, you know, so – you know, you bring in a new coordinator and he puts in a new offense, and I guess it gave him the leverage to do that when he went out to hire him, knowing that, you know, they were on thin ice anyway. So I don't know, Chuck.
What a lousy decision. Just a lousy decision. I mean,
well, and then, you know, he's never been a head coach before, so all of a sudden he's making decisions for the entire team, not just that defensive side of the ball. And that's some people are ready for that and some aren't. But unfortunately, Mississippi State did not give him long to fail or succeed. I think he coached in 11 games. So that's not a big resume of what you can do or can't do.
You know, I tell you what, though, it's the more you look around, coaching is the only profession that you can fail at and leave there a multimillionaire. I mean, I've never seen anything like it. It's just, you know, Jimbo's going to get $19 million within the next 60 days and then $7.9 million a year until 2031.
They might ought to be looking at the guy that did that contract, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I agree with that.
But back to Arnett and State, I think this is really – this works. I think State's created some momentum, right? Now they don't have the alumni wanting, you know, Arnett fired every game, and the players don't have to hear about that. It's just kind of weight lifted off their shoulders. I think, you know, we've seen that with the Raiders and the NFL this season when they made a coaching change, the spark they've received. I think this really does help Mississippi State kind of get that onus off their back and just know that, you know, they could just concentrate on this Egg Bowl.
Well, guys, all I got to do is go back 50 years, and I went through the same scenario. Third game of the season, fired the head coach and the athletic director on a Monday night, brought John Vault back. So I've been there and lived that, and it really does lift the pressure off of you.
Yeah, yeah. And, you know, the biggest worry, you look at the game Saturday between State and Southern. I believe they had, 64 plays Southern, and, you know, their two linebackers have a combined, 39 or 40 tackles. One had 21. Watson and Jett had 18 for them. So getting those guys blocked is also going to be a key center point. If you can get past those two guys, you can really have a lot of hay against State. But those are two really good football players.
Yeah, they are. They're probably their best two guys by far on the defensive side, Yancey. I don't think there's any doubt about that. What few highlights I've seen so far, it's always Jett Johnson involved in it. And he's been a really good player. Had some interceptions, and I think he had one the other day against Southern, picked it off and then flipped it over to DB, and he ran it all the way back for a touchdown. So that was one of their late scores in that game. It was 26-20 to that point. I think that that opened it up pretty wide. But, yeah, so, do the Rebels have the best roster? We do. We're playing down there. We got a hostile crowd. I think the pressure is certainly off Mississippi State. So we got to play. We got to play much better than we did the first half against ULM, and we got a good four quarters. So it's not. It's never easy to win down there. Been down there and done that before, but it's not an easy place to win there. And so I think this staff gets it. I had a chance to speak with Pete Golden today, and they're working on it hard, and everybody's out there after it. And we got a few guys banged up ourselves, so. It's all next man up, whoever that is. But we got to have a great effort come Thursday night.
Well, and the thing of it is, Harry, two other motivating factors for Mississippi State is not only could they become bowl eligible, but as well as I do, anytime they can beat us, that's like salvaging a season, no matter how bad their season is.
No doubt. That's no doubt, Chuck. You absolutely nailed it right there. If they could somehow come away with a victory over Ole Miss, it would make their season absolutely, I won't say perfect, but it'll be pretty darn close for them.
Well, Harry, we really appreciate the time and look forward to hearing you Thursday night on the radio and radio show.
Look forward to it. We'll be leaving with Kellen probably early afternoon, getting on down there and getting settled in. So we'll be
there. Brother. We'll be safe.
Thank you, buddy. Hotty toddy.
Take your earplugs.
And the game day outlook there is presented by our good buddy Bobby Dunlap there at Gateway Tires. He's serving for close to 75 years now, Gateway Tires, and over 50 locations. And now let's get on to the C Spire Connerly Trophy Award watch list that we are presenting each week on the Rebel Yell Hotline. We pick a school for each team, all 10 colleges here in the state of Mississippi, and it's presented by the C Spire Connerly Trophy. C Spire with the Connerly Trophy, the inception in 1996, and the award will be given out, I guess, next Tuesday, Chucky, on Tuesday at the Mississippi Sports Hall of Fame. So let's start it off with the Ole Miss Rebels.
The junior quarterback Jackson Dart, the player of the week for the Rebs, a 6'3", 205-pounder out of Kaysville, Utah, threw for 310 yards and a trio of touchdowns in only three quarters of play in the Rebels' 35-3 win over UL Monroe. Jackson now has 2,891 yards passing and 21 touchdowns on the season. The number 12 ranked and 9-2 Rebels face MSU Thursday.
For Mississippi State, we just talked about it a little bit earlier. Senior linebacker Jet Johnson is our player of the week for the Dawgs. The 230-pound linebacker out of Tupelo, Mississippi, had 18 tackles, a sack, a tackle and a half for a loss, and an interception in State's 41-20 win over Southern Miss. Jet now has 117 tackles, 6 sacks, and 3 interceptions on the season. Johnson has been nominated as one of the 10 finalists for the Connerly Trophy Award. The 5-6 Dawgs face Ole Miss Thursday.
Southern Miss senior linebacker Hayes Maples is the player of the week for the Eagles. 230-pound inside linebacker out of Hattiesburg had a game-high 11 tackles in Southern's 41-20 loss to State. The 3-7 Eagles face Troy Saturday in their season finale, and that's no bargain there. Troy's pretty good.
Yeah, tough season for the Eagles. Jackson State senior wide receiver Fabian McCray is our player of the week for the Tigers. The 6'2", 195-pounder out of Chicago had 6 catches for 109 yards and a pair of touchdowns in Jackson State's 29-29 loss to Alcorn State. Fabian now has 41 catches for 584 yards and 4 touchdowns on the season.
Junior wide receiver Carrick Ross is the player of the week for Mississippi Valley State. The 5'11 receiver out of Itabena has 3 catches for 94 yards and a pair of touchdowns in Valley's 30-21 loss to Alabama A&M. Valley finished a woeful 1-10 on the season.
Poor Valley, it's been rough over the last several years for them. Alcorn State, what a big win for them, by the way. Senior wide receiver Montario Hunt is our player of the week for the Braves. The Walnut, Mississippi native had 2 catches, Chucky, for 88 yards, but both of them went for a score. Hunt now has 33 catches for 555 yards and four touchdowns on the season. Again, Alcorn State was able to beat Jackson State, which is not done very much these days.
Well, here's that guy again. Yep. Senior quarterback Patrick Shegog is the player of the week for the Delta State Statesman. The 200-pound quarterback out of South Panola passed for 318 yards and six touchdowns in Delta State's 49-14 win over West Florida in the first round of the D2 playoffs. Shegog has thrown for over 250 and 31 touchdowns while rushing for 568 yards and 11 touchdowns. Johnson has been, Shegog has been nominated as one of the 10 finalists for the Connolly Trophy.
Yeah, that's, excuse me there, for the typo there, 2,568 yards that he's passed on for the season. There's been a lot of talk that maybe he could give, Judkins a run for that award coming up. And, who could argue he's having a monster year? Look at those numbers. Mississippi College senior running back Marcus Williams out of Donaldsville, Louisiana, has been nominated as one of the 10 finalists for the Connolly Trophy. Marcus rushed for 943 yards and three touchdowns on the season.
Junior punter Ethan Klaplach out of Chicago has been nominated as one of 10 finalists for the Connolly Trophy for Millsaps College. He finished the season ranked second in NCAA Division III with 45.8 average yards per punt.
Call him Lane. Belhaven, lastly here, senior running back Colby Blunt out of Mobile has been nominated as one of the 10 finalists for the Connolly Trophy. The 220-pound native out of Mobile rushed for 1,333 yards and 17 touchdowns, and more importantly, helped Belhaven to his first ever playoff appearance in D3. We'll be right back with the good, bad, and ugly. I don't know she's all right. She's all right, she's all
right. Rebel fans, do you have real estate questions? Coldwell Banker Signature agents have the answers. Whether you're buying or selling, let the agents at Coldwell Banker Signature give you the home field advantage. Start your search now, www.oxford38655.com, or call them directly at 662-50-38655. Also, if you're thinking about a career in real estate, give Martin a call at 662-50-38655 to learn about the opportunities available. Find your home with Coldwell Banker Signature today.
Never miss the game and never miss the party at the Library Sports Bar in Oxford. Grab a seat and a cocktail in the sports bar to watch the game on one of their many big screen TVs. Move on into the middle bar for some great live music Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night. Enjoy a breeze, a beer, and a ball game out on their patio as well. Stop in for happy hour from 3 to 7 during the weekdays. Have a big old time at the biggest bar in town. Meet you at the Brewery, the Library Sports Bar on South 11th in Oxford.
Are you looking for a quality used car at a price fit for your budget? No Worries Automotive Group has locations in Batesville, Olive Branch, South Haven, and Memphis. No credit check, no driver's license, no worries. Every vehicle comes with a 30-month, 30,000-mile service contract. Let our friendly and knowledgeable sales staff help you find the car you deserve. Remember, we have locations in Batesville, Olive Branch, South Haven, and Memphis. Find us anytime, anywhere at noworriescars.com.
Cannon Cleary McGraw is ranked Oxford's number one real estate firm because of fans like you. The agents of Cannon Cleary McGraw are true experts in their field, and it shows with hundreds of five-star reviews and unwavering commitment to their clients. Cannon Cleary McGraw experts specialize in game day condos, seasonal townhomes, and high-end single-family homes. If you are on the sidelines and ready to get in the game, give a Cannon Cleary McGraw agent a call today at 662-371-1000. Tilt the odds in your favor of getting what you want with the best service in Oxford at Cannon Cleary McGraw Real Estate.
With over 40 years of combined experience, the Tom Smith Land and Homes team, serving the Cleveland, Mississippi area, is committed to achieving the best results for buyers and sellers. Their knowledge and expertise about agricultural, hunting, and recreational lands is highly known and respected throughout the state. With Tom Smith Land and Homes, you can expect more and get more return on your real estate investment.
Contact Tom Smith Land and Homes today at 662-441-2500.
Looking for the right place to get your game day colors? Rebel Rags has the largest selection of Ole Miss merchandise anywhere, including football jerseys in every size and color. Come grab them while supplies last. Rebel Rags also has game day polos, sideline gear, tailgate items, and more. Famous name brands like Nike, Under Armour, Columbia, Drake, Coliseum, Champion, and Comfort Color T-shirts. Check out Rebel Rags' new entrance off Jackson Avenue with plenty of parking, or shop online at rebelrags.net. Rebel Rags, owned and operated by Rebel fans for Rebel fans. Tell them, Molly.
Rebel Rags, anything, everything, Ole Miss.
More of the Rebel Yell Hotline, presented by Cannon Motors, coming up next.
Welcome back here to the Cannon Motors Rebel Yell Hotline. We'd like to thank our partners here at Farese Group. With nearly two decades of experience helping retirees invest and distribute their savings, the Farese Group continues to provide their clients with unparalleled level of service and delivered results. They have locations in Ridgeland, Oxford, Little Rock, and Baton Rouge. Give them a call toll-free, 1-877-327-3735. And the next part of the show here is brought to you the Red and Blue Chips. You know, there was, Chuck, a lot of guys in town this past weekend. I didn't know if that was going to be a good thing or a bad thing with the attendance. And, you know, it was attended, I thought, you know, pretty solid considering the circumstances there against Georgia. It's not anything like it's been the prior games of the season.
I don't think that hurt recruiting at all.
Yeah, but, you know, the good part of that is they get more time with them, the early game, to go tour around with the families, show them. But a lot of good players in, including Braylon Stonka Burnside out of Starkville. Everybody knows about him, the four-star wide receiver. You know, he's the tea leaves are really pointing towards Oxford right now. He'll announce his decision at the Under Armour All-American game coming up here on January the 2nd. A trio of four-star defensive line commits for Ole Miss, and Cam Franklin out of Lake Cormont, Jeffrey Rush out of Pascagoula, and edge rusher Raymond Collins, JUCO player there in the state of Mississippi at Jones Community College. Another edge rusher committed Ole Miss, and Cameron Clark out of Tennessee, and Ole Miss safety commit Andy Jaffe were also in attendance. A pair of defensive back targets out of Alabama, four-star cornerback Jaden Lewis and safety prospect Therian Alexander were also in town. And then a couple younger targets, Chucky, 2025 Lake Cormont four-star linebacker Jacoby Hobson. Obviously, he's teammates there with Cam Franklin, will be a big target for Ole Miss next year. And 2026 four-star wide receiver Jess Matthews out of Greene County were also in town. And lastly, Ole Miss baseball news here. The 2024 Ole Miss baseball class finished number five in perfect games with 12 top 500 signees and five inside of the top 100. So that was really good to see. A lot of people, Chuck, think that, you know, Ole Miss just signs these top five classes every year and they've got all this talent, but that couldn't be farther from the truth. It's usually one top class and then one, you know, in that 18 to 25 range, and then one in the 40 to 50 range. So, but now with the NIL, it's kind of balancing out, and this is three classes in a row here with Bianco, the first time ever. So we should start seeing some of the benefits of that coming over the next few seasons, hopefully starting with this year. And the Red and Blue Chips segment is presented by the Grove Collective. You know how important they are. Their mission is to create and enhance NIL opportunities for all Ole Miss student athletes while providing a level of protection and guidance in today's NIL marketplace. Join the collective today to help make an impact with our student athletes who give their all for our flagship university. And Chucky, we're going to go now to the good, bad, and ugly that's sponsored by Cannon Motors. It's find your location near you or see their selection of new and used cars. Go to CannonMotorsCompany.com.
Well, the Rebels obviously notched their ninth win of the season, defeating ULM Saturday in the vault, and ended up 7-0 at home this season. They'll be gunning for their 10th win of the regular season for the second time in 3 years when they travel to Starkville Thursday night to take on Mississippi State on ESPN. The Rebels had a good second half against the Warhawks after only leading 7-3 at halftime. They scored 28 points and didn't allow ULM another point in the 35-3 victory, and they did it with a makeshift offensive line. When I first heard about Chris Beard's idea to have a game in the Tad Pad, I thought it was a pretty dumb idea. Man, was I wrong. It was a great atmosphere Friday night. It was a great pleasure to shake hands with former coach Rob Evans, who was honored at the game, and I hope that Beard does that every year. It was really exciting in there. Only 4,500 people were allowed in because the Oxford or Lafayette County Fire Marshal said that's all that they could allow. I believe they could have sold it out. I really do. And the fans there were really enthusiastic. It was a great day, and I was so, so wrong. The bad, it took the Rebels way too long to put the Warhawks away Saturday. The first half was a comedy of errors and sleepwalking through the game on both sides of the ball. The offense kept shooting themselves in the foot, and the defense just didn't look very crisp either, allowing ULM to mount a little bit of a rushing attack, surprisingly. So the Rebels have to come out of the chute strong Thursday night in Starkville. Harry made a great point. I thought our defensive line should feast on their offensive line, but I'm sure they're thinking the same thing, that their defensive line can feast on Ole Miss's offensive line. So it's going to be an interesting match Thursday night.
Speaking of basketball, a little SEC news here brought to you by Van Atkins Jewelry. You know, as Chuck says, she's always worth it. Coach Yo won tournament here coming up at the Battle for Atlantis. They beat Michigan today 60-49. Madison Scott was named MVP. Congratulations, Coach Yo. And thank you for putting up with me today, trying to host here. Gary Darby, we wish you back next week, and we will see you back next week. Hotty toddy.